Hi guys, today I will be testing out Johnson's baby powder as a baking slash makeup powder. I am so excited to do this experiment, this trick today, because I'm honestly just really curious to find out if this works or not. Is this going to be a good replacement for your fancy dancy makeup powder, or is it something that you should just really use for babies? Or if you watched my previous video, you would know that this is also a really good dry shampoo substitute, so you could also use it for that. But we don't yet know if this is a good substitute for a makeup powder, but we're about to find that out. So anyway, without further ado, let's just jump into the application process. I will be applying it in front of your eyes. I will be showing you how everything looks. I'll be talking you through the entire thing, and we'll be able to see just ultimately, does this work as a makeup powder or does it not? All right, so I have my foundation done, but nothing else done other than obviously eye makeup. So for my concealing, I will be using one of my favorite drugstore concealers called Maybelline Instant Age Rewind. I love, love, love this concealer. My color is called Light. As you can see, I've been using it a lot because half of it, well, a third of it's gone and the cap's all dirty. So you know it's been used and well loved. So let's go ahead and give that a whirl and see how that goes. As you can see, I'm concealing like everything pretty much. Let me just bring this up. I'm gonna go ahead and blend my concealer out with a beauty blender that's dampened and needs to be washed. And by the way, if you do need to wash your beauty blender as well, I made a video recently that showed how I wash my beauty blender. It's a really quick and inexpensive method, and I will leave that video linked down below if you're curious. I really should pin my hair back, but the curls look so nice, I can't bear myself to do it. Now let's go ahead and start baking with baby powder. I never thought I would say that ever in my entire life, but here we are today and we're about to do it. So I brought a little glass dish with me that I'm gonna use as a dispenser for baking powder, because this really doesn't have a way for me to like take the cap off, put the powder in, whoop, hello, put the powder in and then dip my beauty blender into that. So you kind of need an extra dish. So I have that here. My dish is also fancy. I think it was 50 cents from Walmart. What I'm gonna do first is I'm gonna give my skin a really light dusting of this baby powder slash face powder, just to prep it for the loads of powder that I'm gonna be applying on it in a second. I think it's gonna make me cakey. Oh no. Darn. All right, you know what? I haven't even baked yet. I can't really say that it's gonna make me cakey until I actually do it and see the cakiness going on. I think life is giving me hints, because if my beauty blender is already looking cakey, what's my skin gonna look like in a second? We're about to find out. All right. You can see I'm trying to like delay this because I'm nervous. Okay, let's just go ahead and start. Actually, this powder is really fine. That part of it I love for baking. I mean, look how smooth it's going on. So maybe I said that it was gonna make me cakey too soon. I don't like the smell of baby powder though. I don't know if maybe that's just me. Obviously, smell is super personal. I actually did a review on the Coty Airspun powder, and that smell is so strong, and it's kind of similar to the baby powder smell where it's like a powdery scent. I don't like that scent either, but that scent, that Coty Airspun powder scent, is way stronger than the baby powder, even though they're in the same family of scents. But yeah, I just, maybe it's me, maybe I just don't like those kinds of scents. Maybe I prefer my powder to have no scent. And maybe you like that scent, maybe you actually enjoy that, so I don't know. All right, I think I need more powder. We're slowly but surely running out of it. See, this is why cheap powder for baking is essential. Cheap powder is better than expensive powder, as far as obviously cost, because you're gonna be using a lot of it for baking. I mean, look how much I'm using already. So expensive powder is gonna go by quick. But actually, baby powder is a handy thing to have around, because I did a video on dry shampoo substitutes, and baby powder is one of the best dry shampoo substitutes if you are in a hurry and you ran out of your dry shampoo and you desperately need to get rid of the oils in your hair. Baby powder is amazing and it's inexpensive and it's just something that's really easy to keep in your makeup drawer as a kind of an emergency item. Now, I actually like to do this side swoopy thingy after I'm done with contouring, but I figured today I'm gonna do it all at once. I literally have clumps of baby powder on my lap. Ugh. Good thing I'm wearing like a $2 pair of sweatpants. All right, while the powder is setting in and baking my face, I'm gonna go ahead and do a little bit of contouring. For my contouring powder, I'll be using Too Faced Chocolate Soleil, which I like to call Chocolate Soleil because I'm classy and I don't know how to pronounce French. Pardon my French, as they say. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and take a Real Techniques blush brush and just do a little bit of quick contouring just while my baking is setting. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and just stop contouring for right now because I don't want to over contour or under contour. I just want to take this baking off and be able to see my face and then finish contouring wherever I need to finish contouring. So I think we're ready to take the powder off. It's been a couple minutes and I can see it's done all the work that it probably needs to get done. So I'm gonna take the same brush I used to dust the powder on in the beginning of this video, the e.l.f. Complexion brush, like a $3 amazing brush that I've been using for years. And I'm just gonna dust this baby powder off. So before I go ahead and finish up my makeup real quick, I just want to show you what my skin looks like right now. Just give you a closer look at the texture of the skin and how everything is looking. Like you can see, especially the under eye area, it's just kind of crusty and over powdered. And yes, I know with baking you're like, hello, you just applied like 3 tons of powder on your face, but it doesn't usually happen. Like, that's why celebrities bake their face. It doesn't end up happening, but obviously with baby powder it does. Alright, so I'm just gonna go quickly finish with my contouring and I'll be right back and show you the final look. Alright, so I am back with my makeup all nice and finished and I'm here to give you a closer look at my makeup so you can see the texture of the skin, how everything is coming together now that I have everything on my skin that I think I need to have. My makeup routine is quite long and cumbersome, but I enjoy it, so I guess it's not cumbersome technically, but if you didn't enjoy it, you would definitely think it was cumbersome. And this is totally off topic. My camera has a hard time picking up texture, like fine texture of the skin. So maybe you're not seeing exactly what I'm seeing in real life. So in case you're not, I'm gonna go ahead and say what I'm seeing in the mirror. My skin doesn't look terrible. I actually don't think it performed terrible at all. I'm really happy with the result, in fact. However, I do notice some crustiness, some dryness underneath my eyes here that doesn't typically happen. Now, if you're not using a quality powder, I guess that could happen to you, but for me personally, it really doesn't happen ever, really. At least to this extent. And I do notice it right now after using baby powder. So honestly, two things. Number one is that this baby powder did a really good job, considering that it's really not a makeup powder, but it still did a good enough job, a decent job. And in fact, if I didn't know that I was using a baby powder and I couldn't smell it, I would think I was using a kind of a medium quality powder that just happened to not work really well for baking. But the fact that this is a baby powder that's not really meant for baking or makeuping in general, that's amazing that it was able to perform that well, but it's not an ideal powder in my opinion. So it's not something that I would be using on a daily basis. However, this is again one of those items that is so good to have in your makeup drawer because in the case of an emergency, a makeup emergency, you can use it both for your hair if you run out of dry shampoo, or you can use it for powder if you run out of your powder. So yeah, that is it for my video. I hope you guys found this helpful, interesting, something something. If you have any questions or comments, leave those in the comment section below. So anyway, I will see you in the next video and have an awesome day. Bye.